And the glasses are the medium. And then from there you said, Dharmadhatu stava, Dharmadhatu, interest of Dharmadhatu, right? So you have the consciousness coming. So there are three things: the object, the subject, and the medium. Okay, six objects, six subjects, six mediums. Total how many?
18.
18. These are known as the 18 elements. These 18 elements constitute the whole universe. Okay, so we see that the 38. Now we'll go a little faster. So it's about the three things. The three things, for example, with the first one is the sight. Yes, object, visual object as a sight, as an object, and your eye consciousness as the consciousness, and the eye sense power as the medium. These things, through the combination of these three things, then the perception takes place. Perception of the sight takes place. So perception of sight takes place by dependence on these three factors. And each of these three factors, they also come into existence by dependence on their own factors. For example, what is a flower? The object, the flower, is also made of atoms. And the flower is just metal designated. And your consciousness is also made of temporal parts. The flower is made of directional parts, physical parts. Mind, consciousness, does not have physical parts. It has a temporal parts. Temporal parts meaning?
Time.
Parts in time. What do you mean by parts in time?
Minutes, seconds.
Yes. The mind, I'm seeing this, okay, look at this flower for 5 seconds. Okay, look at it for this, your last chance, 5 seconds. Right? Okay, so you saw this flower for 5 seconds. So you have the eye consciousness for 5 seconds, right? First second eye consciousness, second eye consciousness, third, fourth, fifth, five. So this eye consciousness lasts for 5 seconds. This eye, overall, we see as eye consciousness. Somebody's the rosary, mother, very quick. Okay, let's say we see this as a rosary. Actually, it's made of the individual beads. Individual beads are not rosary. But we see this as a rosary, right? We see this as a garland. Likewise, say the eye consciousness, the mind, we see this as a, okay, mind existing for 5 seconds, like a stream. You see a stream. The 5 seconds lasting mind, as though like this, one mind there, stretched mind. Actually, there's no stretched mind. It's just made of five moments, like the five beads. Five beads, they make the rosary. The beads, they made the rosary. Likewise, they are the five moments. And even the first moment, the first second mind, is also made of 1,000 milliseconds. 1,000 pieces, small pieces. What are these pieces known as? Temporal parts. Temporal meaning in time. These parts are parts in time, not the physical parts. Okay. So, okay, now we're going to go a little faster. 38. In dependence upon iron form, appearances without a stain occur. From being unborn and unceasing, the Dharmadhatu will be utterly known. Okay, so what really exists there is the emptiness of object existence. That is the Dharmadhatu. From this Dharmadhatu, this emptiness, then the object appears as the sight, and then the consciousness arises, and then the sense power arises. From being unborn and unceasing, meaning objectively unborn, objectively not ceasing, the Dharmadhatu will be utterly known. This is how the Dharmadhatu manifests in the form of a known phenomena, as an object, as an eye consciousness, so forth. 39. It depends upon sound in ear. Now it's about the sound. Sound is the object, and the ear as the sense power, as the medium. Pure consciousness comes forth. From this arises the ear consciousness, three things. All three Dharmadhatu without sign. So these three things, the sound. What is the base of the sound? It's the emptiness of sound. That's the basis. That's the Dharmadhatu, right? And then the emptiness of the ear. That's the basis of the ear. Emptiness of the ear consciousness is the basis of the ear consciousness. So these three are the true nature, the Dharmadhatu. all three Dharmadhatu without signs. Without signs meaning that in the ultimate analysis, we see that they don't have, oh, this is a sound which is different from, for example, let's say, there's a sign, say, what is that sign? How can we read Hebrew?
Exit.
So that is a sign to say that this exit, right? Don't exit from this, right? It's also exit, two exits. Not from the middle, right? Not from the middle, not from here. Don't exit from here, don't exit from here. These are two exits. So these are the signs. Likewise, they say that this has what? This has a sign of roastery. I'm a roastery, I'm not a chocolate. You're getting it? This has a sign. A sign meaning, so you see something from which tells us the information. This gives us the information, this is exit. This is not exit, this is not exit. Likewise, this has a sign, different sign, which says that I'm not a chocolate. I'm not a flower. You getting it? This is a sign. Okay, so in the ultimate analysis, all these signs dissolve. You getting it? To the distinctions, all these distinctions. What is sign? Sign is a distinction. You're right, for example, when we go to the shower room, the boys, girls. It's just a picture of one round thing, and then it's like different thing, and then you say, oh, this is for the girls, this is for the boys. But this picture is not a boy, this picture is not a girl, right? But from there, it is conventionally a sign. From this we get information, different information. Now all this information in the form of signs dissolve in the eyes of the ultimate analysis. Okay, we'll stop here. Let's not be too ambitious. What time we come back?
11.
Okay.
25 minutes.
Okay.